Hi everyone, so let us discuss modular arithmetic. So let us define first. In modular arithmetic, numbers are reduced within a certain range defined by the modulus. For the integers a and b and a positive integer n, we say that a is congruent to b modulo n if their difference is an integer multiple of n. So in simple, so this denoted as a is congruent to b modulo n. So in modular arithmetic, we are only interested with the remainder. Example of this is the clock. For example, if now is 7 a.m., after 5 hours, it will be 12 p.m. And then after another 1 hour, the time is 1 p.m. and not 13 p.m. Okay, so that is, the clock is under modulo 12. Another example is the days of the week. So if today is Monday, after seven days, it will be Monday again. So that's a modulo 7. Okay? So again, in modular arithmetic, we are only interested in the remainder. So if a is congruent to b modulo n, this will be our remainder. This is called the residue, and n is the modulus. So A is congruent to B modulo N, that means N divides their difference A minus B. Or in equation, that means A is equal to, using the division algorithm, A is equal to N times the quotient and then plus B. So B here is the remainder. Okay? So if we have A is congruent to B modulo N, that means N divides A minus B, or A is equal to NQ, N is the modulus, Q is the quotient, and then plus B, this is the remainder. Okay, so example, if we have 7 congruent to 2 modulo 5, so let's verify if this is true. We can write this as 7 is equal to 5 times what number, and then plus the remainder. So 7 is equal to 5 times 1 plus 2. So this is true. 7 is congruent to 2 modulo 5. And also, 5, using this, so we have 5 divides their difference, 7 minus 2. 7 minus 2 is 5. So therefore, 5 divides 5. So that is true. Another example, so we have 9. Is congruent to 4 modulo 5. So again, this is true because let's use divisibility first. So 5 divides the modulus, 5 divides their difference, 9 minus 4. 9 minus 4 is 5. So therefore, 5 divides 5. So this is true. And also, we can translate this into 9 is equal to 5 times what number? So we have 1 plus 4. Okay, so that is the remainder. And then another example, so we have 2 is congruent to negative 3 modulo 5. So if we apply this one, so we have the modulus is 5. 5 divides the difference, 2 minus, we have negative 3. So 2 minus negative 3, that will become 5 divides, this will become plus, so 2 plus 3 is 5. So again, 5 divides 5. So therefore, this is also true. And also 2 is equal to, if we use this, NQ plus B, so 2 is equal to 5 times what number, and then plus this negative 3. So the value of this is 2 plus 5 times, this will be 1. 5 times 1 is 5, and then plus negative 3, that will be 2. Okay, so another example, let's try this, find the answer to this. So if we have, let's calculate 47 modulo 7, and then 98 modulo 15. So what is the remainder to this 47 modulo 7 and 98 modulo 15? So to solve this, all we have to do is divide and then find the remainder. Or we can express in division algorithm, 47, that is equal to 7 times what number, and then let's find the remainder. So 47 divided by 7, that is 6. 7 times 6 is equal to 42, and then what is the remainder? The remainder is 5. Therefore, 47 is congruent to 5 modulo 7. Okay, so we just need to divide and then get the remainder. So another example, we have 98 modulo 15. So this is equal to 98 is congruent to blank modulo 15. So what is the answer? Let's just divide. 98 divided by 15, the answer will be 6. 98 is equal to 15 times 6, that is equal to 90. And then plus the remainder is 8. So therefore, 98 is congruent to 8 modulo 15. So usually, the value of B is positive number that is less than, greatest positive number that is less than our modulus. So modulus is 7, so the answer is 5. And then we have, for number 2, modulo 15, so our answer is 8. But again, we can add or subtract multiples of our modulus 7 in here. So we can add 7 to 5. So this is also equal to 47 congruent to 5 plus 7, that is equal to 12. So this is the same, 12 modulo 7. And we can subtract multiples of 5, add multiple of 5. So we can change 5 to 12. And then also 12 plus 7, we have 19. So that's the same. Plus another 7, so that is 26. Or we can subtract, we can use negative number. Okay? So now let us apply discuss the operations addition, multiplication, subtraction, and division to modular arithmetic. Okay? So we have properties for... Let us discuss first the modular addition. So according to modular addition, if we have a plus b modulo n, this is equal to a modulo n and then plus b modulo n. Okay, so let's take this example. If we have 27 plus 19 modulo 7. So let us apply this property. If we have a plus b modulo n, that is equal to a modulo n plus b modulo n. So we just simply distribute the modulo n to a plus b. Okay, so let's verify. First, let's add this 27 plus 19. That is equal to 27 plus 19, so that is equal to 49 plus 7, so that's 16. So we have 46 modulo 7. So what is the answer if to 46 modulo 7? So what is the remainder? So the remainder, so we have 46, that is equal to, divided by 7, so that is 7 times 6, that is 42, and then the remainder is 4. Therefore, 46 is congruent to 4 modulo 7. So let us verify if we get the modulo of 27 modulo 7 and then 19 modulo 7, if the answer is also 4. Okay? So let's apply the property. So we have 27 modulo 7 plus 19 modulo 7. So what is the remainder to this 27 modulo 7? 27 is equal to 7 times 3, that is 21. Okay, and then plus 6, so the remainder is 6. And then for 19, we have 19 is equal to 7 times what number? We have 9 times 2 or 7 times 2, that is 14. So 14 plus 5. So the remainder here is 5. And then let's add the remainder, 6 plus 5, that is equal to 11. So what is the remainder of 11 modulo modulo 7. So 11 modulo 7, so let's just subtract 11 modulo 7. So we have 11 is equal to 7 times 1 plus 4. So therefore, 11 is congruent to 4 modulo 7, which is the same to this. Okay? So that means we can add the two numbers and then get the modulo, yan, get the remainder, modulo 7, that is equal to, if we get the remainder for the first number and then add the remainder to 19 when we divide that to our modulus 7. Okay, so this is also applicable for subtraction. So if we have A minus B modulo N, so just change the operation to minus. So we have A modulo N minus B modulo N. Okay? So now we proceed to the multiplication, modular multiplication. So if we have A times B modulo N, that is equal to A mod N times B mod N. So let's take this example. We have 23 times 17 modulo 5. Okay, so modulo 5, so that is, it is easy to find the remainder. So if we apply this property, 23 times 17 modulo 5, that is equal to, get the remainder of 23 mod 5. So that is equal to 23 modulo 5 and then multiplied by 17 modulo 5. Okay? So first, let us multiply this 23 times 17. 23 times 17, that will give us 391. So 391 modulo 5. So what is the remainder when we divide 391 to 5? So the remainder to this is 1. Because in order to be divisible by 5, the last digit should be 0 or 5. Okay? So the remainder obviously is 1. So 391 is congruent to 1 modulo 5. Okay, so let us verify if the remainder when we get their product, 23 modulo 5 times 17 modulo 5. So the remainder to this, since our modulus is 5, remainder of this is 3. And then the remainder of this 17 mod 5, the remainder of this is 2. Okay? And then if we multiply this 3 times 2, the answer is 6. And then 6 is congruent to, what is the remainder when 6 is divided by 5? 6 is congruent to 1 modulo 5. Okay, so we got same answer, the remainder is 1. Okay? So for division, the property, we will use other property for division of modular arithmetic. So we have another formula for division. We have A over B modulo N. A over B modulo N, this is equal to A times the inverse of B. Inverse of B, if exists, and then mod N. So I will upload another video for this because we will use the inverse of modulo in this property modular division A over B mod N. We cannot apply this, so that is not equal to A modulo N divided by B modulo N. So this is not equal to this. So the property is A times the inverse of B if exists and then modulo N. Okay, I will upload another video for this. I will upload first the inverse of A modular arithmetic. Okay, so that's all for today. So see you on my next video about solution of linear congruence. Bye-bye.